Hi, do you want to meet the favorite child of the father of modern surgery? Are you interested in knowing what is a donkey engine? Yes, you are at the right place. Pharmachemistry Vibes has brought you today phenol. What are phenols? Look at these compounds. Aromatic ring wherein oxygen in the form of hydroxyl group directly attached to the ring. The group of such compounds is called as phenols. So we have example of cresol, nitrophenols, catechol, resorcinol, quinol, several others wherein oxygen as a hydroxy group should be directly attached to the ring. Whereas if it is attached to the carbon and then to the ring, then still they are only aromatic alcohols. Hydroxyl group attached to the carbon will always make it alcohol, but when it is attached to the carbon which is part of the ring will only make it phenol. Phenol was first isolated in 1834 by a German scientist, Friedrich Runge. He isolated it from the coal tar, and we have already seen coal tar gives different fractions as light oil, middle oil, heavy oil, which is very rich in aromatics like benzene, toluene, xylene and lot of other aromatic compounds. So when phenol was obtained from them, it was seen that it is having acidic properties which are usually not shown by other aromatic compounds. So it was named as carbol saure, which means an acid obtained from coal oil. And then later on, carbolic acid name became much more popular. It was a French chemist, Charles Gehard, who gave the name phenol in 1843 to this compound. And in that era, phenol was more popular by the name of carbolic acid. But who gave most of the recognition to phenol? Yes. He was the father of antisepsis and modern surgery, Joseph Lister. Born just few years before phenol, but he treated phenol like his child because it was a breakthrough use of phenol in the antisepsis, which changed the way surgery worked. And that is why Joseph Lister is regarded as the father of antisepsis and modern surgery. He was a Scottish surgeon, and all the surgeons along with him at that time were struggling that almost half of the patients were dying not because of the surgery but because of the wound infections they were getting after the surgery. Lister was brilliant enough to know that patients are being killed by germs. So he was constantly thinking what he can do to kill the germs. How can he clean the wounds? One of his colleagues suggested him to read an article published by Louis Pasteur few years before, wherein Lister noted that Pasteur has recommended three important procedures for killing the germs: filtration, exposure to heat and exposure to chemicals, out of which filtration and exposure to heat was not at all possible for the patients. So he was thinking what he can do with the chemicals. In his lab, he tried with different chemicals, but he did not get the success. By some way, he came to know that in France, people are using carbolic acid for the sewage treatment to reduce the smell of the sewage and also to prevent infections to the animals. He thought, if carbolic acid can prevent infection, can it be used in the antisepsis? He was waiting to experiment, and that day came. On August 12, 1865, he got a patient who was 11-year-old boy who has got a fracture in his tibia bone, which even pierced the skin of his lower leg. Usually at that time, In such situations, surgical cutting of the bone was the only option, but Lister wanted to try something different. But he was not knowing how. He was, at that time, he got carbolic acid. He literally soaked clean cotton towels into undiluted carbolic acid and applied it onto the wound, covered it nicely, and then left it for 4 days. After 4 days, when he checked, to his surprise, there were no infection. Just there was a redness at the edges of the wound because of the burning caused by carbolic acid. So he decided to decrease the strength. He reapplied the fresh bandages with diluted carbolic acid. And after a few days, the boy was successfully able to walk home after his treatment. And this is where the history of modern surgery changed. The death rate, which was almost 50%, came down to only 15%, and that too, carbolic acid was not the reason. Soon he developed something called as a donkey engine, through which he used to pump carbolic acid through the whole operation theater. He used to clean surgical instruments as well as he used to focus the vapors on the wound. The results were so great, soon other surgeons decided to use his techniques of antisepsis. Do read these amazing books if you are more interested. Germ theory and its applications to medicine, and on the antiseptic principles of the practice of surgery, Louis Pasteur and Joseph Lister. There is another amazing book by Lindsay who says, The Butchering Art. It is the love story between science and medicine, wherein all the era before Joseph Lister and after Joseph Lister, she has explained about the surgery. Lister not only saved lives of the patients, but he also influenced lives of several other people. One person attended his lecture in 1876 at Philadelphia Centennial Exposition and started a business to make mass-produced sterile surgical products. Because at that time, surgeons used to compound all the necessary things by their own, as well as sterilizing them or disinfecting them with this carbolic acid. So there was a need for production of such surgical products. So this is a story of one big brand called Johnson & Johnson. One of the Johnson brothers attended this exposition and he was so impressed by his lecture that he decided to enter into this business. Previously, he was having partnership with some other person, but because Johnson believed that this antisepsis is the future of modern surgery and he must go on the lines of Joseph Lister, he broke the partnership and started this Johnson & Johnson business with his two young brothers. Several years later, when Lister came to know about this good company, Lister sent a letter to this company asking what type of procedures they are following. This is a reply of Johnson & Johnson to the Lister, who clearly says that this is all due to you, and the whole system of modern medicine and treatment and the manufacturing of the materials has been made possible largely by your labors. You can actually visit homepage of Johnson & Johnson and read their story in their own words. Many doctors in the audience, they did not believe Lister at that time, but Johnson was convinced that this is the future of medicine. So because he was inspired by Lister's antiseptic methods, he parted ways with his business partner Siburi, and then he started with his two younger brothers Johnson & Johnson, and the first thing they produced was the mass production of sterile surgical supplies. Another inspiration, Joseph Lawrence, was also got so much inspired with the Joseph Lister that he formulated a surgical antiseptic and he gave the name as Listerine. He sold his formula to a pharmacist called Lambert, who later on joined with Warner, and now their company is owned by Pfizer. They have a big range of products, right from the germicide mouthwash to the teeth whitening tips. Still, Listerine is a brand name which they have adopted just because they got inspired from the Joseph Lister. These are some references to the information and images. You can read the detailed story of Johnson & Johnson on their website. You can also read about donkey engine. So I'm sure now you are interested in the phenols. In the upcoming videos, we will see structure of phenol in detail, its physical and chemical properties, its acidity as compared to other functional groups, and its uses. Till then, take care. Goodbye.